My name is Nel Patrick A. Baya. I'm 27 years old. I grew up in a religious family, but as a child, I don't take it seriously. Then when I turned 18, I work in the BPO industry, and that industry is very vast, I would say, or complex. So we get to experience, or rather get to know people about their different beliefs, their the way they live. So I was exposed in a belief wherein God doesn't really exist. So as I go along, grew up with those people, I eventually adapted to how they behave, how they basically do their normal routine. So basically live without God. Nung una kong iisipin mo, kung dededmay mo lang yung mga nangyayari sa paligid mo, madali lang siya. Pero at the same time, there's a part of me that is feeling a void, na parang may kulang lagi. So I have happiness, then at the same time, may part na malungkot talaga ako. Like, pag malungkot, sobrang lungkot. Like, depression, anxiety, and whatnot. Sobrang lala nang nangyayari sa akin ng pandemic. There's no right words to explain it, but I made a lot of bad decisions, I would say. I say not hurt physically people, but rather emotionally hurt people. To a point na nagsisinungaling na ako. I no longer have a certain identity at that point. So I don't know myself eh. So I don't have any sense of direction. To a point na na-depressed na ako. Then talagang kinain na ako ng lungkot. I still remember that the first in the long time na nagdasal ako. It was June 13 of 2020 at 8:30 p.m. The reason why I still remember it is because how I prayed to God. I've never prayed to God na nakaluhod. I was so scared of my life that I almost ended it. I just wanna fight it at the very last moment. Na parang kahit paano naniwala ako sa kanya. Di siya nag-give up sa akin. So what I prayed for is basically I wanna have a chance of life. I wanna be happy again. I want to grow faith. So 3 days after, I was so curious about social media. So I was playing around social media and whatnot. So whoever comes up there, I don't really care. I don't really mind that time. I just want to have fun. Kasi parang feeling ko, naging masaya ako somehow. Kasi kinuusap ko ulit siya. So yun, nakita ko si Nika. So then I added her because we have common friends. Nag-curious ako. Tapos chinat ko siya. Parang sugal lang. Kung di niya ako i-chat, fine. Not a problem. If mag-reply siya, alam mo, magkausap lang kami. Ayun. Then, conversation goes on. Then, I didn't realize na siya pala yung magiging instrument para malapit ako kay God. Kasi she asked me this one question that really stunned me. Na I never really expected that from her. Tinanong niya ako, do you believe that Lord Jesus Christ is your Savior? Then, nung kinausap ko kasi nung gabing nga si Lord, sinabi ko, kung sino magbigay sa akin ng sign na maniwala ako sa iyo, na manaling ako sa iyo, bigay ko yung buhay ko sa iyo, babalik ako. Yung question na yun that hits me. That's the sign. So, I've told her, yes, I believe that Lord Jesus Christ is my Savior. Nung time na in-ask niya ako ng question na yun, then that's when the time I told her that I need help. So, one time, parang I wasn't joining ICS yet. Na-curious ako sa kanya. Sabi niya, sana mag-church daw siya. Wala, sabi ko, walang church kasi pandemic eh. Online. Ako, sige, join ako. So, that's the very first somehow service ko talaga. Nung lumipat ako ng Makati, then that's the time that I was fully introduced to ICS. Yun yan, physical service. Nagkaroon na face-to-face service, rather. After that, it opened a lot of rooms, which is to have me join a circle. Yung circle helped me to answer my questions na, alam mo yun, mga hindi pa na-answer when I was still young. Dahil dun sa Alpha class na junin ko, yun. Isa yun sa mga instrumento na meron ng ICS, sa mga katanungan na meron isang tao about God. Life is too short for it not to have God. Kasi na-feel ko yung void eh. Na-feel ko yung lagi may kulang. I see the sense of achievement when I do things where I don't believe in Him. But at the same time, I'm not happy. So the least thing that you want to happen to yourself if is nandun ka sa last day mo and hindi ka naging masaya, lagi may kulang. And late mo na nakilala sa Lord. When I found Jesus in my life, I've opened myself na maging mapagpatawad na tao, mapagpasensya na tao. Like, mas uunahin ko na lang yung pag-unawa kaysa unahin ng galit. My name is Neil Patrick Baya. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have experienced life change.